of the Court of Appeals denies the bid of former Senator Laila De Lima to also prosecute several witnesses against her and the drug cases she is currently facing. In her motion, De Lima insisted that if the charge against her is conspiracy to commit illegal drug trading, then those who claim to have conspired with her should also be prosecuted. Among them, former Bureau of Corrections officer in charge, Rafael Ragos, and over a dozen drug-convicted witnesses. But the CA stood by its October 2021 consolidated decision, reiterating that the right to prosecute vests the public prosecutors with a wide range of discretion, including what and whom to charge. De Lima, who has been in jail since 2017, has yet to react on the CA decision.
The Philippines formally asked Indonesia to grant executive clemency to Filipino death row convict Mary Jane Veloso. Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo communicated the request to his Indonesian counterpart, Retno Marsudi, on the sidelines of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s state visit there. Veloso has been detained for over a decade after being convicted for drug smuggling, but her family claims she was framed by illegal recruiters. Veloso was granted a reprieve in 2015 with the help of then-President Benigno Aquino III.
Ayon kay Minister Marsudi, ihahain nila at isasangguni sa kanilang Ministry of Justice. Samantala naman, tuloy-tuloy ang pagbigay ng consular services ng ating embahada kay Ms. Veloso, at ayon sa kanila ay nasa mabuting kalagayan siya sa Wonosari Women's Penitentiary sa Yogyakarta. Ikinuha din siya ng abogado ng ayon sa batas ng Indonesia nang tuluyang maprotektahan si Ms. Veloso.
Overseas Workers Group Migrante welcomes the efforts made by the DFA on Veloso's behalf. Still, it expresses disappointment that Marcos himself did not raise the matter with Indonesian President Joko Widodo, saying he seemed to have downgraded the issue.
President Marcos, meanwhile, leaves Indonesia with some $8.5 billion worth of investment pledges. These include $822 million for investments in textiles, garments, renewable energy, and agri-food. Meanwhile, there's $7 billion worth of investments in infrastructure for unsolicited private-public partnerships and a $662 million trade value for supply of coal and fertilizer. Malacanang expects these investments to generate at least 7,000 new jobs.
Trade between Indonesia and the Philippines increased by 50% in 21. Yun lamang, there's a trade imbalance really between Indonesia and the Philippines. So I said we should find ways to turn that around.
During his state visit, Marcos also sought Indonesia's help in improving the fisheries sector in the Philippines. He says it's unacceptable that the Philippines is importing mackerel scad, locally known as galunggo.
I asked for help because matibay ang fisheries nila. So sabi ko, we can exchange delegations. That I think we can. Those are the things, especially in the agricultural sector, are going to happen in the very short term.
President Marcos meets with the Filipino community at the start of his two-day state visit in Singapore. About 1,500 Filipinos trooped to the National University of Singapore to see the president. Marcos recognized the big contributions of overseas Filipino workers from Singapore since they became the second highest source of remittances last year. He also thanked them for helping propel him to the presidency.
Ito yung pagbabago na dinala ng ating Secretary Toots Oplek. Ay sabi niya, alagaan natin yung mga OFW, ngunit huwag natin kakalimutan, alagaan din natin ang kanilang pamilya sa pamamagitan ng mga scholarship, pamamagitan ng healthcare, pamamagitan ng housing. Yan po ang aming tinatrabaho ngayon at nasisimulaan na natin para naman yung trabaho ninyo ay hindi nyo na kailangan isipin ang kalagayan ng inyong mga mahal sa buhay. Makakaasa po kayo na ako, kasama ang ating kabinete, ang ating mga opisyal, ay puspusang magtatrabaho upang makamit ang inaasam-asam nating pag-asenso.
Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Oble, meanwhile, revealed there will be more employment opportunities for Filipino health workers in Singapore.
Mismong gobyerno ng Singapore ang nag-reach out sa atin, andito yung ambassador ng Singapore sa Pilipinas, at humihingi po sila ng karagdagan ng mga Filipino health workers dahil sobrang napabilib po sila ng ating mga manggagawa nung panahon ng pandemya. Kaya bukas po, isa sa mga lalagdaan ay isang joint communique with the Ministry of Health na nakasad po doon ang kanilang paniniwala, ang kanilang kagustuhan na maka-hire pa po ng mga Filipino health workers natin. At nangako po silang aalagaan sila ng husto.
Marcos will meet with Singaporean President Halimah Yacob and Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong today. They will witness the signing of other deals, tackling efforts on counterterrorism and data protection and privacy. He will also attend the Philippine Economic Briefing and Roundtable discussion with businessmen to attract investment deals for the country.